I want you to imagine that my arm is a timeline. And here is the start of defined time. In the middle is all of civilized life, when sentience entered the pipeline. About 50,000 years of cities, towns, and theories up until we're the ones in the limelight. That's fine, right? Okay, then after this hindsight, we have the millions and millions of years of future, where billions of civilians will be soon, yeah? Now, given this opinion, and since computers are getting better and better, according to Moore's law, they'll exponentially develop, eventually exceeding the power of the human brain, at around 11 more years at the concluded rate, but anyway. If you could wait a little longer, it'd be true to say that computers gain the cumulative brain power of the human race. So soon you could make a simulation of nature. A virtual universe that, for all intents and purposes, is basically a version of the world, like the Matrix. So just to clarify, we've got past, then centuries of present here, then potentially there's several million years of future where you can emulate the world today within your brain. Okay, now with that said, is it more likely to hear that you were born within this relatively tiny time period, or that you're currently in these millions of years here, trying to find an interesting experience? Is it more probable that you're one of just 7 billion people living in this follicle, or that you're part of the phenomenal volume of humans in this anthropological future? The logical conclusion seems obvious. Because when you finally come to the thought that the whole of science, culture, and law are compressed to this tiny mole on my forearm, compared to the eons ahead of us, it seems like some serious evidence. Well, if you assume that somewhere between here and my wrist that humans don't go nearly extinct through nuclear warfare, or there are new brutal transgenic diseases we're not immune to that cause a pandemic to cease us, and it would be just too much to suggest that around here on this appendage that anarchy precedes an unprecedented level of unemployment and overpopulation, and that pollution doesn't make the ozone stop negating UV radiation, and we rule out new ice ages or orbital invasions from horrible aliens, then our next probable destination as a species is technological innovation to the degrees I described. If anything, it seems more contrived to imply that our lives started right at the time in which science made strides and it finally guided society to new heights. Now, you might just be finding this mighty exciting, or deny that it's likely and try criticizing, but I will remind you that I'm just describing an idea I think is quite an inspiring one. And the icing on the cake is the enticing implications, but analyzing them can wait for another time and another day. Yes, Moore's law is just a prediction, so all this thought is potentially fictional, and even if we did invent this pivotal instrument capable of inflicting our craniums with pictures of places, which sounds ace, it just takes us up until the point where the sun swells and makes this planet bake and frazzle. Unless we seriously work on our space travel, but hey, have a think about it. It's just an interesting concept I thought up and wanted to share. Oh, and I forgot to say, hi, I'm Dave, and now I'll wave you goodbye with these eons of time. Have a nice day.